Hello everyone, this is Take from BigHeadTalk.com and welcome to my studio. Just doing a quick announcement of my upcoming trip to Hong Kong. I'm going to call it BHT HK 2018. No big surprise. And I've been talking about it for the last couple of weeks on all my various social media platforms. But this trip initially was because I was going to Jakarta, the Monogram Asia 8x8 Jakarta event. And I was going to kind of use Hong Kong as my hub city. And I already made a few plans to do different things in Hong Kong. But because that trip was canceled, there was no funding for me to get there. And so a lot of my friends really wanted me to go there and they kind of rallied me to make the trip anyways. And so I thought I would talk about what I'm gonna be doing there and what review cameras I'll be taking. So let's start now. Number one, the Konica Hexar. This camera here is fantastic. I've been wanting to properly review for a long time, and this is from the dark room in San Clemente, California. So thank you Philip and Trev and the rest of the team. So they sent this to me to review, and the dark room gave me tons of film. And so just one second, in here what do we have? We have Tri-X 400. I got six rolls of that, and I have T-Max 400. I got six rolls of that. So T-Max there, Tri-X over here, and this is like not from Kodak, this is from the darkroom, so thank you guys. And tons of like consumer films. I love the Color Plus 200. This is fantastic film. I tested it before, and so I'm not gonna have a lot of fun shooting with this. And then like just a whole bunch of even like Fujifilm. This is a CA. The CA135, so this is extra, I guess. This is Fujifilm Extra 200, I think that's what this is. And there must be like 20 rolls of that in here. Thank you guys for all the film, and thank you for sending me the Konica Hexar to test in Hong Kong. 35 f/2, it has a maximum shutter speed of 1/250th of a second, but I just put ND filters and you know, be able to handle that and still be able to shoot f/2. But I'm gonna be primarily shooting it at night with CineStill. Look how many rolls of CineStill film that I was sent. Now this was actually sent by CineStill. So thank you Brian and Brandon and the rest of the team down in California. You guys know how much I love shooting CineStill and shooting CineStill in Hong Kong, and so is focusing on that CineStill 120 and lots of 135, the CineStill 135. And I'll be using this, a lot of this film with the shutter lines. It is once every other week on a Saturday afternoon. And so I'm gonna do one of the photo walks. We're gonna make it into an evening photo walk, and we will be shooting with CineStill film at night. And so I'm gonna create a unique hashtag. I haven't decided yet what I'm gonna call it. BHT underscore CineStill underscore SA for shutter lines 2018 or something like that. And then we're all gonna use that hashtag and post all the pictures that we take using CineStill. I'm excited for all the film I'll be shooting. And I will be reviewing I've been showing this on my Instagram feed a lot, is the Leica M7 with the 28 Summicron. And so this one here is a special edition. It has the L can, right? So Earnest Lights Canada, a 50th anniversary M7, and they only made 50 of them. And so I'll be reviewing this. So I'm gonna have, and it's funny because this Summicron has a 46mm filter thread. The Hexar has a same 46mm filter thread. So I'll be using the same, probably the ND filter. You can see size-wise, they're very similar, but I'm gonna have a 28 f/2 and a 35 f/2. Yeah, so these are my two main film cameras I'll be shooting with. Now this is a camera that everyone's been talking about, and I've been talking about it. It is the new X-H1. This is the beast of a camera slash video. From what I'm looking at, comparing the GH5 and the Sony A7 series, this is probably the best implementation of a camera, like a stills slash video camera. The other two, the GH5 and the A7S Mark II or III, whatever it's on, those are very strong for video. Not that they're not strong for stills as well, but so I'll be testing this for video as well as for stills. If you are a Fujifilm shooter and you are wondering, should I get the X-H1 or should I keep the X-T2, or if you don't have the X-T2, should I upgrade, you know, which one should I get? Well, I'm gonna kind of go over that on my trip to Hong Kong. And right now I'm shooting this video on the X-E3. I'm shooting this on the X-E3 with the 23 F2. The last trip that I made to Hong Kong, I took the X-E3 and I didn't take the X-T2 or any X series body as a backup. I fully trusted the X-E3 because I had tested it enough to know that I was pretty confident. So on this trip, I'm taking the X-H1 and I'm going to take either the X-E3 or the X-T2. I haven't decided which one. I'm leaning towards the X-E3 for vlogging and keeping everything lightweight. And then this is a pretty big monster, like in terms of even the eye cup, the extra grip, you're getting quite a bit. It's more about the back, because you know, this is gonna be, I do a lot of, like, I carry this all day around my neck or side carry. When you side carry, you know, that eyepiece is pushing up against your body. So, you know, I'll be doing a thorough video and stills test of the X-H1 in Hong Kong. And so those are all my main review gear. Mike Padua, he's one of my sponsors, because like I said, a lot of my friends rallied and wanted to support me in this trip. So Mike is gonna be sending me some stuff to do some giveaways and some little projects as well. He's offered to cover all of my film processing. So thank you so much, Mike. You are an amazing guy. As well as Vishal from Camera Film Photo. He's like, how can I help? What can I do for you? And I have some ideas, but I want to discuss it with them in person. So Vishal, thank you for your support. Number one is really Barton 1972, Victor and Carmen. I've been in a few videos with them. I consider them good friends. This is one of their straps right here, the muddy green military strap. They knew that, you know, that trip to Jakarta by Monogram Asia was going to subsidize the trip, and because that subsidy was pulled away, there was no paid job, and so they actually paid for my ticket to go to Hong Kong. Without their support, as well as the support of all these other brands, but especially for Barton 1972, without them I wouldn't be making this trip. And so thank you guys so much, and I'm going to have a lot of fun hanging out with Barton, with the Shutter Alliance, with Camera Film Photo. There's quite a few other little projects I haven't talked about. Maybe I'll kind of hint a little bit. Mint, Gary, the RF70. There's a few videos I have planned, but the main thing is really to be going there, hanging out with the Shutter Alliance, shooting a bunch of film, and talking about the photography culture in Hong Kong, as well as film culture, but not just film culture, but photography in general. So I'm really looking forward to the trip. Thank you, Camera Girl, for letting me go again. It might seem like I just got back from Hong Kong, but I came back in early December. There was a family emergency, and so I had to take 2 months off. And so I do have videos from the last trip, and now I'm going back again, but that was 4 months ago. So it has been 4 months since I've been to Hong Kong. So I'm kind of itching to go back again, and lots of cool projects upcoming. So stay tuned. Thanks for watching. Thanks for your support. Don't forget to like, don't forget to comment. And I don't mention this very often, but at the very bottom of all my videos, I do mention that, you know, for those of you who do want to support, I've been thinking about doing Patreon, but at this point I don't want to. I want to do it kind of per project, but because a lot of my expenses have been covered, some of it hasn't been. So if you wish to help out financially, I do have a PayPal account, and all the details will be at the very bottom. I don't want to talk about it too much, but if you want to help, you sure can, and I really appreciate it. You don't have to. You could just enjoy the content and support me by liking my videos and commenting, and that is great as well. So thanks for watching, and I'm gonna close off with this here. Thanks for watching. The next time you'll see me in Hong Kong. So we'll talk to you soon, and happy shooting. That's it.